Hi, welcome to Take 5, Goa Institute of Management's very own mini chat show. This is day 3 of Awesome Rookie 2014, and we have with us Ms. Gloria Benny, the co-founder of Make a Difference. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, at a very young age, you've co-founded Make a Difference. You've also left Google, which is a dream company for many of us, to pursue your own dreams. What basically inspired you? What motivated you to do this?
It would be primarily from a young age, I loved working with children. So I knew that I would end up, or I would want to end up my career with, in that space, working with children per se. And while I love my job in Google, it was a very enriching experience. After 5 years there, I knew it was the right time to make that shift and work with children again. Secondly, I think what was also very important for me was to find slightly higher meaning and purpose, and hence MAD could give me both, allow me to work with children and give me a higher meaning and purpose. So it was just the right choice at the right time.
The MAD model, social model of entrepreneurship, has been appreciated by Michelle Obama. Right. So what are the differentiating factors you see in MAD's model and the other social organizations present in India?
Differentiating factors, I guess the most important one and the primary one would be that MAD is like a platform. It allows youngsters to come on that platform and leverage it to help children. So we allow, the model is based on volunteerism, which is very new at the time when it started. And that was one big USP for us. It allows a lot of Indian youth to come in and understand the social problems and do something towards that without having to give up on what they, what they're currently doing. I think that's one of our biggest USPs. And the second thing about a model is that if you join MAD as a volunteer, it allows you to interact with people not just in your city but across 23 cities in the country. So that is great networking and very rich diversity of people that you get to know just when you're in college, which otherwise would never really happen to you unless you start working somewhere. So the whole diversity brings in, and it really brings in a lot of growth for a college student just looking to learn. So if you're between the age of 18 and 23 when you're really, really thirsty to learn, MAD offers a platform which, with this kind of scale, I don't see that in a lot of other nonprofits.
So today MAD is such a big brand. I mean, have you had any strategies basically to promote or make a difference? What were your marketing strategies basically?
Okay, so that's easy. So essentially, because our target audience is usually the youth, because we need volunteers to teach our children, we've gone really big on social media. So if you look at Facebook, we have over 2 lakh fans. So all of our marketing and branding is primarily on social media and Twitter, Facebook and Twitter. We also do campaigns, course array campaigns. So if there's Students Day, we do campaigns during that time. We reach out to as many youth as possible and getting them to get aware about the vulnerable children in their community. So in terms of branding and marketing, it's been social media that's really, really changed the landscape for us.
Ma'am, have you had any challenges while going about, implementing your decisions, or maybe in terms of funding or getting volunteers? What were primarily your challenges that you faced?
Yeah, so I guess early on our challenge was that we were a little young, we were only 19, and we wanted to do something that was really huge. So getting people to really take us seriously was an early on challenge. Would you, believe a 20-year-old coming and asking you for funding because you want to change the face of the community in India? So early on, age was a challenge for us because we were young. Later on, I guess our biggest challenge was working with the shelters and ensuring that we're able to deliver the kind of programs we want and getting the buy-in of the shelters to ensure that gets done. Now our challenge is. Essentially, wouldn't say it's a challenge, but it's where we're going to move towards is ensuring that our program, we really understand the problem and we're going much deeper, and getting specialized talent onto the MAD team is something that we're really looking to build, which we built a little bit, but we like to improve on that. So getting specialists to the nonprofit space, getting the right talent is possibly our next big challenge which we're looking forward to.
Oh man, we as a VS school, you know, really believe in giving back to society. We have a Give Goa initiative that, you know, does a lot to the Goan community and to really empower the young children here. So what is your take on that? Like, what do you feel about this initiative?
Yeah, so I heard about it on my way here. It was very unique. Every Thursday,
right.
Going out into the community and doing something. I have not seen another B school do that. So I think it's really amazing. It's a platform for the students to their first touch point with the social problem in the Goan community. So that's really amazing. Usually B schools do consulting projects with nonprofits, but never really get on the ground. So this is very new and. I think it's a great, great initiative by the college.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.